come to get my sleigh here and a couple boxes. I had some old moose scraps down there in the bottom, and look, Mr. Lynx was up on my box. There's his track right there. Hope he didn't get a chicken. Little bugger. I let the chickens out in the daytime, or open the door for them anyway. Most of them stay in, but so I had to make a set for that guy. I should just leave that there and go get a treat. Nah, I'll do it later.
Morning. I had a lynx coming. Killed three turkeys I had left. Hey, hey, get back up here. Come on, I got two 330 boxes set down here. Looks like one has moved. I got my trail camera on it. Oh yeah. I don't know where he's gone, but he's there. Hey, hey. Sit. I got him.
It's not a big one.
Oh, I don't know. Bugger.
I had three turkeys left. I killed four. I got them on trail camera. I knew he wasn't a real big one, but didn't take long. I put another box there for my trail camera. Four inch to the side there. And I was going to work. He only killed two, and I was going to work, so I opened up the door and let the other one out so it'd have a chance, and I come back and he killed that one too and dragged it over in the woods over there. So I tracked it down. Okay, we get him taken out of here. I gotta go to work.
So the shop returned the slinks that I got down there on my by my chicken coop. I was very surprised with him, actually. He's got some spots there. Oh, the light's shining right on there now, so you flatten them out to show up better, but I was very surprised at how gray he was. Got him a lot worse this time of year. He is in the light there now, but he's pretty good, considering he's they're a lot browner down around here. It's only 20th of November, so it's a male. He was 22 pounds. He's right there. Not a bit of fat on him, not a bit. But he got a full turkey head in his gut there. Turkey head in the neck and part of the breast. And that one's gonna go for bait. Nothing wasted. Yeah. What to do now? I gotta get this lumber out here. I got all the other stuff out, so this is all pine. That's gotta go in my truck and go down to my sawmill shed. And well, it's Monday, I finish shift Wednesday, and then it's out to the line, do some setting. I got some beaver there. Stinking up. I got the fur on it this time. I usually skin them, and then, but this one was just a small one. I hardly had any fat on them at all, so. So I'm gonna try to set some Martin sets. See, I'd like to see what's out there. Like, give it a shot anyway, because I usually only, if I see a track, I'll set a box or two or something. But I'm gonna try to go into some different area. The winter, I've been there before, but it's been quite a while. So got some beaver there for my Wolverine boxes, some turkey guts and beaver gut. And part of the turkey there, what I didn't keep. I'll hang that for a couple, three sets. Yeah, so. Getting geared up. My nephew just went and got me some dragnet twine to fix my snowshoes. $14 for a roll of dragnet twine, and it was $27 to send it. From Newfoundland. So, yeah, I guess I'll go in. I don't know what else to do tonight. I could make some more wolf snares, but I get at that, and then next thing you know, it's 2 o'clock in the morning. It takes a little while to make a few. Maybe I'll cut some cable. Yeah, I might do that. I might do that. I cut mine about 15 feet. Yeah, you have your chain on your trap 15 feet. Yep. Shorter your chain, the further they'll go. And I have my snares longer because sometimes all you got is a big aspen to tie it around. So there goes 3 feet there. Then you got a big loop and it's 3 or 4 feet in your loop. If you have like a 18, 20 inch loop or so. So it doesn't take long to use it up. And sometimes your tree is not close to where you want to put your snare. So I don't add extensions or nothing. I don't put anything on there any more than I got to for breaking points. But everyone, to each his own. Do what you think is best or what works for you. So, yeah, I guess, the next thing, be out on the line. All loaded up, went and bought a new sleigh for breaking trail, lighter one, because my other one I made is a bit heavy to be trying to move around when you're breaking trail. Nowhere to turn around. Tarped in all my stuff so it wouldn't be snowing in all the time. I got her full. Bait, fuel, food, couple 330 boxes, a bunch of 330s. I didn't take no 120s, but I got a couple out there. I'm just gonna try to break trail. Didn't take no wolf bait. Gonna try to get some trails in and probably come home to get some stuff for bait piles. So beautiful evening here. Yeah, all day. Time I got back from town, but I got her done. This is a 91 inch Pelican. It's the only one I could find, so it's my Christmas gift for this year, I guess. Made it to camp. Wolverine came right down my trail, almost to camp, and then he went out around. That's good. First time I think I've seen a Wolverine track here. We're at that camp. There's a fox around here too. Not much, didn't see a wolf track, I don't think. I think it was just that Wolverine out there going around. Get stuff unloaded now. Get the plywood took down. Get the fire lit. Yeah, not as much snow out here as at my house and at work. Dog's all full of sniffs. Met my buddy on the way out. He brought me up some smoked salmon he done. He lives down in the interior. He works up here. So I met him and he dropped me off a couple pieces of salmon. So I'm having some beans and bread. Dog just finished his supper. Got no lights here, just light. Generator's warming up there by the stove. I might start it. I might not. It's about 9:30 p.m. Got here about 8:30. Ooh, that light's bright. Yeah. Always waiting for handouts, eh? You just eat a big bowl of food, guts. He said, well, you cut me nuts out. I got nothing else to think about. So, I don't know tomorrow what I'll get. Probably won't get much set. I think I'm just going to try to open up some trails. And things is ugly. Ugly. Everything's rigged full of snow. So, got to try to make a plan this year and just stick to it and try to get a road in that I can just make a loop or something. I'm tired of jumping around everywhere. I'm not worried about wasting time because I'm not a herd adder. I still get a bit of fur. So, never seen a wolf track though. So, they're around somewhere. They'll show up and you'll think there's 100 of them. Hey, shade. Huh? You need your eyes wiped out. Huh? Okay, gonna finish my supper.
Just setting the first Martin box of the season. I don't know if I'll have many out or not. You sit. Sit. I'm gonna try Bass's long distance call lure. Couple guys from Iowa, brothers, Mark Bass. Pretty sure his name's Mark. So we're gonna give this a try here. It's in timber. Usually pick up a couple Martin around here. Not many, but we're gonna try it here since it's the first one. And I'll try it elsewhere at my 330 boxes. He messaged me and asked me if I'd, just a second, if I'd try it out. So nothing to lose. Sure to work. It's got skunk base, so everything else works with skunk. So I'm gonna get it on here. I'm gonna need two hands. So I'll get some glabbed on here somewhere. There she is. It's a creamy color. Not sure if it's what's he using for base. It's minus, it's only minus 10, so won't be able to tell till later. How hard it gets when it gets colder. Got a piece of beaver leg in there. Hey, Shade. You remember, keep your nose out of that trap. Feels good to set a couple traps, I tell you. I don't know why. This year it feels a little different, but we'll see what hiccups we have. I've been fighting my left hand. I'm left-handed. A lot of people probably know, but I got carpal tunnel in it, I guess, or arthritis. I think it's carpal tunnel, though, because my fingers are still, two inside fingers are numb. And now my last week or so, I've had my forefinger's been bad, like lightning bolts going up at it. So I've been wearing a brace in the nighttime too, especially so I don't bend my wrists and stuff. So I'm dealing with it. I haven't went to the doctor yet, but last resort. I stay away from prescription drugs and doctors. so might have to get surgery though. But I'll hold it as long as I can. Just set a Martin box. And I use Bass Brothers long distance call lure again. Skunky. Just like it's in mine, only I got a bunch of other stuff added to my lure. Which I've said before. Come on. Focus. Farmingville, Iowa. Give them a call. I'm sure it'll work. I could smell it when I went away there, so. The old Martin. He's got a beaver tail and some meat off the tail. Just a small beaver I had, so I got a leg in the other one. It's not tainted or anything. It's just pretty fresh, so. There she is. Okay. Gonna head down the trail. But he's a good dog. He's getting better every day. Hey. See, when I talk to him, then he thinks he can come in. He's been sitting out there ever since I started. Are you a good boy? He is a good boy. Old Skidoo's still going. Almost 13,000 kilometers on it. Just trying to clear some lumber out of my shop so I can get her in and do some work on her service. And the handlebars is a bit loose, so I'm not sure what I'm going to do there, if I'm going to be able to fix it myself or not. We'll see.